Okay, so today we're building the SaneSmart Jimitsu CNC Router 3018 Pro Kit, which is significantly easier to build than the just regular 3018 kit because of the fact you have pre-cut panels instead of more aluminum extrusions like this. So first off, what we're going to do is we are going to grab the base plate with the large hole in the center. Grab the two shorter rods and two of the longer screws, which are the 15 millimeter ones, or 16, along with the two short and fat aluminum extrusions, and then another four of the longer screws right here. So you're going to stick screws through the holes and stick this guy on. I would not tighten it up all the way with this one, just for the first part of the assembly, just so that way you're able to square the machine easier. So there's still a good bit of play and wiggle in there. It's not completely tight. So now let's go and do the other side. These aluminum extrusions are already self-tapped, so you don't have to worry about that. However, there might be a bit of metal in the extrusion still. The whole area to make it a little harder to get the screw in sometimes, but not hard enough to be an issue. Now let's connect up the rods the same way. Again, not tighten all the way. In there. It's a little loose, but that's completely fine. Now let's grab one of our NEMA 17 stepper motors and one of our adapters. Note how there is not screws in one side, but the other side has both screw holes filled. And then one hole is smaller than the other. Take the smaller hole and stick it over this one, but pay attention to the notch on your stepper motor and make sure that screw lines up with there. That will prevent issues in the future with it slipping. Make sure that guy gets nice and tight because you do not want it to slip. Now take the shorter of your screw rods. Slide it in here. I'm not going to tighten it down yet. And for this step, pay attention to how you have the notches sticking off right here and here. Those are your feet. So with your notches facing away from you, have the port, well, the plug for your stepper motor facing to your right. Slide it in. Flip it over so that it's resting on the stepper motor. Then grab your skinny screws. And screw your motor in. This, make sure to tighten down all the way. We just want these parts loose so that you can later on get it squared easier. Otherwise, you'll have to go back and loosen a bunch of stuff up. Now that we have that there done, grab your other base plate. Make sure that you notice where the bearing is. The bearing is going to be facing inwards, so you don't have it on the outside. And that's going to go over there later. Well, actually, before we do that part, I almost forgot. You need to grab your bearings and pay attention to where the screw holes are, because the fact that I'm going to first off rotate this guy so that the top is facing you, because this is going to be the top of the machine where you have the platform on. Make sure that these guys, the screws are closer to the bottom. That's going to maximize your build area, or your effective cutting area more of. And then for the secondary ones, slide it over and make sure they're facing towards the top. Just like that. Now, next, you want to grab a spring, this part here, which is for the screw, and one of the other threaded parts. Stick the spring in, stick this guy here in, give it a little spin first off, get started, push down, and then give it a, then turn the screw. Having it loose down here will help with screwing. And now it's through. What that does is it eliminates backlash, so there's a lot less play in the system. And now let's rotate that guy till it's about halfway down, just to make life easier later on. Later on, we'll need to have it about halfway just to even connect the bed. Okay, now let's go back and grab this again. Make sure you have the non-bearing side facing out, the bearing side facing in, and pay attention to where the feet are on it, so that way you can make sure the feet are facing the same direction as the other. Stick it over here. Grab six more of the longer screws. And stick them in. I just realized that this rod was not pushed all the way through. You can tell because you have a little bit sticking up on top. Yep, there you go. Now it's all the way through. Again, I am not tightening this part yet. However, I'm going to make sure that the screw ends up facing down so that whenever I do tighten it, it will work better. In the end, this should be just about flush. Let's finish sticking these guys in. Again, not tightening them all the way down, just a little to make sure that the frame is square and level. Now lay your frame. frame down right here like this. Have the basic frame done. Actually, let's first off grab these guys here. And then the smaller ones, we need to grab a good bit of them. Ten of them to be exact. Alright, they've stopped running away. These guys. Let's flip this guy over here. Make sure bearings facing sideways. Now we're going to give the screws here a little push through. Pay attention to how you have the slope right here in the flat side. You want to make sure that this guy has the slope facing up, and then the flat parts facing down towards the bearing. I'll let you see that. And then just give it a slight turn just so that it's able to stay on, because you do not want to tighten this yet. Otherwise, you will not be able to stick on your cutting plate or platform. Flip it over. Also make sure that they're all facing the same direction, or they all go this way with the channels. So you have the channels there, it's going to be going that way with the build plate. To lift it up, make sure that all your bearings have the tops facing down. Grab the plate here, make sure you have three grooves facing towards this here, and then now you're going to slide it in. the platform is on. Now make sure it's on your table entirely. And let's just tighten these to be a little bit more snug. Still not perfectly tight, making sure that all four corners are touching without wobble. The platform is the hardest part of the build. Luckily, that is almost done. Do not tighten your rods yet, just because we want to make sure that everything is aligned straight. Now flip over the platform. And turn the rod to drive it all the way to one side. It does not matter which side it is. Tighten it up so it's nice and tight there. That way the build platform is held in place. And look down from the top and make sure that you have about the same spacing on each side, which it appears that I do. Now go through and tighten up these guys here so the bearings are stuck in that position. Now that we have this guy tightened up over here, let's tighten up this side of screws. Rotate. Okay. Oh, I almost forgot to tighten up the center. Let's fix that guy quickly. And then before we move to the other side to tighten up the other screws for the rods, let's first off tighten up the screw holding the threaded rod in. Otherwise, if we backtrack it that way, we'll just start pushing the rod out this way. We do not want that right now, so there we go. You want to make sure these guys are super tight, and you might even want to use a Loctite style glue or just some thread lock. Even super glue would work, just to make sure they don't slip in the future if you end up having issues like that down the line. Now just manually turn this guy. Make sure that your stepper motor is not plugged into the board. Otherwise, you can mess up your speed controllers on there, or stepping controllers. And then ram it into the other side. Make sure that's nice and square. Rotate it around. Tighten up the last few screws. are now done with the base of this. It moves pretty freely as long as you turn the rod. It does not allow it to move unless the rod's moving, though, which is a nice feature. So next, we're going to grab this piece here. It has the large hole, not the one with the bearing. And let's go to this side of the machine. Notice how you have the motor back here. So this is the same side that the motor plug's facing out on. And we're going to be grabbing 6 of the longer screws first off. Hand on the back of them so they don't fall out. And now grab 6 of these little nuts. Don't screw them in all the way yet. Make sure to pay attention to their orientation. You want the slope side facing up if you're holding it this way. Do not tighten them all the way down. Just like last time, have them loose so that that way it's easy to connect it to this side. Let's rotate that so you get a better view. And I dropped some. If you want, you can do this one at a time, whichever way works best for you. Now, make sure that they all face in this orientation here. And press it up against the side right there. Push each one in to make sure that it lines up in there. And then what I did beforehand is I marked at the 165.5 millimeter mark from this part here, not the back plate, but right here to right there is 165.5 millimeters, which is what the instructions call for. So I'm lining it up to right there and going through and tightening. This is not something you want to have super tight yet, just so that you are able to make sure that everything is squared, and also it will prevent future binding in the movement of your x-axis with the spindle on it. So just enough so that way you still have a little bit of play of rotation, but the screws are not coming out. And it's going to stay together. So all this is very loose. That one there did a bit too tight. Yeah, so there's a good bit of play still there, which is good. Next, we are going to grab our last motor and another shaft collar, well, adapter. Note again the larger circle and the smaller circle, along with how only one side of it has screws in. Just repeat the steps for doing it on the y-axis. Make sure to pay attention to the key slot and the stepper motor, so that way you get the best connection to it as possible so it won't slip. Again, Loctite or some thread lock or even super glue is a good option for this. Now we're going to take it, make sure the motor faces the back of the machine, which is where the other motor is, right back there. Stick it in. Grab your four last of the thin screws and screw this motor into place. And tighten the motor down. Going to do, just for convenience sake, is make sure that this screw here, which you can see that, faces towards the front of the machine. Now I'm going to grab the two long rods and two more of the longer screws and screw them in right in the hole above the motor and below the motor. Again, I am not tightening these guys down yet, just to make sure I can get everything square. Otherwise, there's a chance you will end up with some binding issues. Now let's grab the threaded rod and just set it in here. Actually, I'm going to loosen this guy first because of the fact that it's a bit too tight for the threaded rod to fit through. There we go. Now it's fit in correctly. Let's rotate so it's facing away from us again. And now let's grab our last two aluminum extrusions and two more long screws and stick it in the very top hole, not the second top hole, but the top one. Let's not tighten it down all the way, just get it snug so it's all some play with it, just like how these guys have some play and all this has some play. And then grab the other one and stick it in the very bottom hole. And again, just snug. Grab the main assembly for the Z-axis and part of the X-axis. Let's grab our spring and our other one of these T-shaped pieces that are threaded in the inside. Stick it through like that. Press down again. Stick it on over here. Give our x-axis a twist until we feel it pop out the other side. There we go. Now let's drive this guy. Actually, since it came undone at the other end, since that's not tightened down yet, let's give it a nice twist to bring it out over here first off. Slide it back into the coupler, like that. There we go. Now, the coupler is still facing the right spot, good. Grab the last one of these pieces here, pay attention to where the bearing is, Pay attention to where there's no bearing. The bearing is going to be facing the inside again. First off, we're going to stick on the no bearing side. Six more of the long screws. Flip it over while making sure they don't fall out. Try fail that. And repeat what we did for the other side. Oh, that's the wrong screw. Again, paying too attention to these guys and make sure that they're in the correct orientation. All face the correct direction again. Just like that. And press it up against here, keeping in mind that I already scratched the 46.5 millimeter mark. Now let's make sure that I get the threaded rod through the correct spot first. Guys in. Move it so it lines up with the 46.5 millimeter mark and get these guys in here loosely on. If you have issues with them getting in the correct spot, you can always loosen and tighten up again. Mark is right there. Just be careful not to completely unthread it, because if you do that, what will happen is you'll have to take the entire side apart again and then make sure that you're able to get this piece out there, the little nut, out of the channel and stick it back in the spot. Tighten that one a little bit much. I'm going to just loosen it up some. Just make sure all these guys are loose. So I want to be able to move it into position and make sure it's all in play. Okay, so it does still have some play. Now let's grab two more of the long screws, stick it in to connect up the back supporting bars. Now let's grab two more to connect up the smooth rods. Which might require some wiggling of the smooth rod. That is okay. This way. Make sure you have movement.
Caleb.
And then we're going to try and tighten this part up here to make sure that the threaded rod is secured. So it's moving freely. Let's run it all the way over to this side here. the smooth rods on this side. Tighten down the aluminum extrusions on this side also. Make sure that you have this area here lined up with your mark, and then let's tighten in this side also. This to the other side. Make sure that runs smooth the entire way. To that side, rotate your machine around, and tighten up threaded rods first. Oh, the smooth rods, not threaded. Tighten up your aluminum extrusions. And then, lastly, tighten up your base after verifying that it's at the correct scratch mark, which mine is. Sure to get these guys nice and tight. I do not feel like it's necessary to use this end, so you get more torque going that way. I would just stick to tightening it this way. I would not be worried about breaking these plates. They appear to be plenty strong. Grab the control board. All the plugs will be on the top of it, minus the screen plug, which is an accessory you're able to buy. Now grab your short ones, stick them through the holes here. Stick on that side a nut with a spacer. Do not tighten all the way down, just like before. And repeat for all four corners. Screw back. Now let's tighten this one on. And now for the last one. Which I apparently lost. Nope, there's the screw. Make sure they're all facing the same direction again. Flip it around, stick it on right here, hold it in place and then tighten down. I would not tighten it too tight just because of the fact that this is a circuit board that you're bolting it down on and you do not have any washers. However, that should be completely fine. Just don't muscle man it. And I accidentally had this one at a bad angle, so that means this guy here is having some issues. There we go. Let's get these guys back in spot. Nice thing about this part of the build is you can actually see if your screws are biting in the correct spot or not. And then if they're not, you just loosen it up some, tighten it back down. Okay, now let's flip the machine back around to the front of it. And get your motor in, and put your wires on. I already did that. Once you stick them on, they do not want to come off with these. Pay attention to where the red dot is. That is your positive. Your motor will be spinning the wrong direction if you mix that up. It will not damage your motor, but it might damage your machine and bits in the long run, just because of the fact that you're going to have issues with your bits not digging in, and that does not work well with a machine, a CNC machine. Down, motors in there good. Now lastly, you can either use this little coupler, which has a larger end and a smaller end again, or you're able to use this coupler here, which is the one I would recommend using more. However, it does not fit on there with ease. You have to either push it on hard or heat this up to 350 degrees using either a torch of some kind, or you can stick it in the oven at 400 for 30 minutes and it should be hot enough. I am going to test that one later on, but for video's sakes, I'm just going to stick this on because it's a lot quicker. And this one here, you do want both sides in. So let's loosen those guys up here. Stick the larger side on the end of the router. Tighten it in. Again, make sure that this is as tight as possible, but do not bend your wrench. Now let's flip it back around to the back. And grab our motor wires. Just grab one of them for now. Pay attention to how you have one that has four on one side and one that has six on one side. However, only four wires go into it. So one side is longer but shorter. The longer but shorter side you plug into the motor. So in this case, I'm plugging it into the Z axis, and I'm going to plug that into the last port, which is for the Z motor. Just like that. Then I'm going to grab another one, again paying attention to the number of ports on it, and I'm going to plug it into the Y-axis motor right down here. And I'm going to plug that into the Y motor. Lastly, we have our x-axis, and that one we're just going to connect up right into the x motor port right there. So it goes x, y, z. And then we have our either motor for the router or a laser. The laser will be there, and I'll be making another video later on for that. This one here, you just plug into place, and you're done. Now, granted, you do want to do wire management, because otherwise this all could get caught up. So let's do that now. Wire management is different for each person on the level of wire management that you do. You do get zip ties with the machine, and I would advise using them. Actually, I'm going to reroute this guy underneath here if it'll fit, just so that, that way you'll hold it in place. So just go right like that, and then connect it up to here. The only wires that will actually be moving are the spindle wires, or the router wires, and the Z-axis motor wires. So let's give it a nice area here, and you want to make sure that these guys are not going to get in the way. So making sure you get them in a nice tight bundle will keep them stiff and out of the way. As you can see, this wire now is less droopy and will stay out of the way easier and still allow it to travel all the way to the other end without interfering with your cutting. And your bit's all the way on the complete opposite side of the machine, so it should not be having any issues there. Now let's just finish off by getting all these wires a little neater. There we go, it's stuck a good bit of zip ties on there. Now I'm just going to use some scissors and snip the ends. There we go, the Jimitsu CNC Router 3018 Pro kit is done. And if you have any issues, there is the Facebook group for this. It's the Sane Smart CNC Router group, and over there we can answer your questions and enjoy your new router. Happy cutting.